Good morning, St. James family. Today is December the 13th, and my name is Kendall Jackson. Just a couple points before we go into the Word of God. I want to start by thanking everyone for tuning in for the mighty Word today. Thank you all to the St. James family. Thank you all to our Facebook family. We hope you enjoy this Word today. Just a couple points before we go in. If you would like to sow a seed into this ministry and you feel truly blessed by the Word today, you can do so by way of Givelify, looking us up under St. James Baptist Church, B.C. Again, that is St. James Baptist Church, B.C. as it is on the screen. You may also come by 11:30 to 12:30. There will be a member here or a trustee here ready to receive your funds in a contactless drop-off. Also, if you're having trouble figuring out Givelify, you can direct message us and a minister or a member will reach out back out to you and get you the information needed so that you can give or sow the seed that you wish to sow. Once again, I do want to just thank you all for tuning in for a mighty Word today. I just want to ready yourselves. I want you to ready yourselves to receive the Word. Grab a pen, grab a paper, grab a notebook, whatever you need to grab so you can take notes, so you can take this Word with you throughout the week. Once again, we love you here at St. James, and we hope you enjoy this message. Thank you.
Good morning, St. James family. I am Minister Ijames, and I am here to be with you this morning as we go through the Word of God. It is my pleasure and my honor that I accepted this assignment from our pastor. In his absence, I stand instead. I want to honor our pastor, Pastor A. Wayne Love, for charging me and trusting me this morning to bring God's Word to you. I also want to give honor to our First Lady, Dr. Love, and our fellow ministers here in the ministry at St. James, and my St. James family for trusting me and being with me this morning, as well as our wonderful Facebook family. I greet you and thank you for being with us in worship. There is a word from the Lord. Our scripture is coming from 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter, verse 12 and verses 26 through 27. I'll be reading from the English Standard Version. Verse 12 says, "For just as the body is one and has many members, and all members of the body, though many, are one body, so is with Christ. If one member suffers, all suffer. If one member is honored, all rejoice together. Now you are the body of Christ and individually members of it." When we meet Paul, Apostle Paul, in this text, we find he is writing another letter to the church of Corinth. He did this many times, as it was his way of connecting with them and encouraging them and helping to give instruction as they walk their journey in this new faith of Christianity. When we get to this particular portion of the letter in chapter 12 in the first of Corinthians, Paul begins by addressing the concerns, and he explains the importance and purpose of spiritual gifts in the body. When we reach verse 12, Paul is going a little bit deeper, and he uses an illustration of the human body to bring a better understanding to the people of God of what he truly meant, as he affirms that just as there is a body of one with many members, so is the body of Christ. Paul continues to follow through with these verses. He continues through the rest of those verses, such as in verse 14, where he utters, "Their body is consisted of not just one member, but of many." He describes the different parts of the body, and he gives a better understanding of the purpose of each part and what the importance they play within the body. This morning, God needs the body of Christ and the body of believers to be encouraged and to be reminded we need each other to survive. Through this past several months, we have all faced many challenges that we've had to navigate through. Within the past few days that have happened to us, things have changed dramatically. When we began this journey with COVID, the first few days we went from being able to hug one another and worship together and to enjoy each other's company. We could hop on a plane and travel anywhere in the world we wanted to go. We could even go to the grocery store and pick up whatever toilet tissue that we want. Now the shelves are empty. Now we're standing 6 feet apart. We have to wear masks. We have to stay in, and we live with the fear of COVID-19. So many of us have struggled with not being able to hug those that you love. If you're like me, you're a hugger and a toucher. You're not able to have those wonderful, normal
wonderful family gatherings that you're used to having. You've gone through financial challenges, employment challenges, and the pause of having corporate worship. The scripture tells us, forsake not the assembly of believers, but we've had to sit in separate places and try to join each other from a virtual standpoint. Like the Church of Corinth, we have become comfortable. We had become comfortable. We had become complacent in many areas. We were unaware that we had taken for granted that the church would just always be open, that the people we love would always be there, and that we could worship together anytime and any way we please. But life took a tragic change. With the present season that we're in, it has caused us to realize that life is precious and life is short. That the person that we keep saying that, oh, I'll call them tomorrow, that person is no longer there. That person that we forgot to give that hug to or that word of encouragement to, we can't do it anymore. That person that we used to always want to say, I love you to, and we'll wait for the next time to tell them, we can no longer tell them. People of God, God needs us to understand that we need each other to survive. I know that the past few months have been tough and they've been challenging and so much pain has gone through us, but believers stay encouraged that we do need each other to survive. We need each other to pray with. We need each other to talk to. We need each other to go with us through these long days and long nights. We need each other when we're at home alone. We need each other to survive. Every one of us has a gift from God that has been placed inside of us that is used to bless the body, and it is needed for such a time as this. Ephesians 2 and 21 tells us, in him, the whole building, the body of Christ, is joined together and rises to become a holy temple of the Lord. We have many different facets of the church, many auxiliaries, many different positions, but those positions do nothing for the body if we are not working and striving to survive together. We need each other. We need that gift that you have that you love to call and check on one another. We need that gift that you love to send a card every now and then. We love that gift that you have that you pray in the spirit and speak word over everyone. Father needs us to understand that we need each other to survive. There is no title. There is no degree. There is nothing that places you in a place that is outside of what God has intended for you to be. In the coming months, it's going to get a little harder. It's going to be a little even more challenging to keep your head up sometimes and to have the faith. But if you remember that we need each other to survive, we will make it. The things that we have to challenge in the body are going to probably rock us even to the very core of who we are. But if we stand together, if we understand that with God we can do everything, and with each other we're even stronger standing together, we can make it, and we need each other to survive. When we find Ecclesiastes in chapter 4, verses 9 through 10, it even encourages us about the importance of it being more than just one person going on a journey together. The scripture tells us that two are better than one. You see, I can go alone if I want to. I can walk this journey just in silence and solitude, but it was so much harder for me to go this trial, or go through this situation, or go through this challenge by myself when I can have a person to go along with me. It says that two are better than one. Why? Because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up the fellow. Believers, we need to understand God wants us to want one another. God wants us to need one another. We have to hold each other together. We need each other to survive. And with God, all things will be possible for us to succeed. Don't take for granted who you have to love on each and every day. Don't take for granted that they will be there the next time you decide to have a conversation with them. And don't doubt your place in the body and the importance of what you have and the gift that God has given for you. It is made for such a time as this. There is nothing that God has done that is out of his order. So I encourage you this morning to understand that we need each other. Reach outside of your comfort zone and pick up the phone every now and then and call someone. Get that card, that all those cards that you have, mail something to somebody. Anytime that you think of someone in your heart and your soul, reach up to the heavens in a prayer. We need you. I need you. We have to walk this journey together. If we walk it together, oh, what a time it will be when the children of God get together one more time. I just want you to remember that the scripture even encourages us to understand that it does get better. Even when we look at verse 26, when it says that when one member suffers, all members suffers. It continues to let us know that if one member is honored, we all rejoice together. Children, remember, weeping may endure for a night, but joy does come in the morning. This season will pass. So let us not forget what it's teaching us. Let us not forget that it is teaching us how to love one another, to not take each other for granted, to be grateful that we have those that we have with us, and to take the time to show love and kindness at every opportunity that we have. Why? Because we need each other to survive. The songwriter Hezekiah Walker made a wonderful song that's one of my favorites. And it says in this, and I'll close with this, I will pray for you and you pray for me. I love you. I need you to survive. I will not harm you with words from my mouth. I love you. I need you to survive. Most gracious Heavenly Father, once again, your word has gone forth for your people. It is a word that is needed for this time and the season that we're in. Now, Father, we need you to do what only you can do. Come into our situations. Come into our homes. Comfort us when we need comforting, God. Speak life into our situations. Bring about an awareness for us to not take each other for granted. Let us show love when we can show love. Let us show kindness when we have an opportunity to show kindness. Though we have a mask on, Lord God, let our eyes show the light of your love and kindness in them so that every person that we meet know that we belong to you. God, I pray that you keep our church family and our Facebook family strong through this season. God, I pray you keep us healthy and strong. Be with those that have lost loved ones through this time of sickness and disease. God, comfort their hearts so they're able to make it and understand that even though they have lost a loved one, God, it is not goodbye, but I will see you later. For to be absent in the body is to be present with the Lord. God, we pray for our pastor, we pray for our first lady, and everyone that's under the sound of my voice. May you keep us, may you help us, may you bring us through this season that we will be able to rejoice in what you are doing. God, we will forever praise you and give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. It's a wonderful opportunity to be with you once again. We love you here at St. James, and may heaven smile upon you. Thank you so much. Goodbye, St. James family, and goodbye, Facebook friends.
What a great word from Minister Dana Imes. I want you to know here at St. James, we do need you to survive, and we love you and we care about you. That is our Facebook family and our real family. We care about you here at St. James, and I personally hope that you took something away from this message today, something that may carry you through the week and something that may stick to you through the rest of your life. Just want to remind you that if you were blessed by this message and you are moved to sow a seed, you can do so by way of Givelify, looking us up at St. James Baptist Church BC on Givelify and look for a picture of our pastor. And then you may also do so by a contactless drop-off between 11:30 and 12:30 here at our church, 1002 West Carolina Avenue. You can drop off your tithes and there will be somebody here to receive it. Just want to thank you in advance for the seed that you're sowing. And I want to praise God for the blessing that he's going to send your way. Once again, I just hope that you enjoyed the message. And I look forward to being with you next week as we hear another fruitful word from our pastor. Thank you again, and we love you here at St. James.